The Philippine government taking a tougher stand on last week's tense encounter in Ayungin Shoal. Manila's top defense official calling the incident a deliberate act by China, contradicting the National Maritime Council's earlier pronouncement it was a mere accident or misunderstanding. Pia Gutierrez reports.
In a departure from its earlier statement, the Philippine government is now saying that the June 17 incident in Ayungin Shoal is neither an accident nor a misunderstanding, but a deliberate act by the Chinese government.
We see the latest incident in Ayungin not as a misunderstanding or an accident. It is a deliberate act of the Chinese officialdom to prevent us from completing our mission. We are not downplaying the incident. It was an aggressive and illegal use of force.
The sudden change in tune comes shortly after President Marcos Jr. visited the injured troops at the Western Command in Palawan, according to Secretary Chodoro.
Preliminary assessment at the time, but after the trip of the President to Palawan, nag-firm up na yung conclusion na talagang deliberate incident.
National Security Advisor Eduardo Anyo, however, reiterates the government's earlier statement that China's actions, earlier condemned as coercive, aggressive, and barbaric by the armed forces of the Philippines, cannot be classified as an armed attack.
Not classify it as armed attack because by international definition of armed attack, it is the use of military force and excessive mass use of force that could trigger collective self-defense. Even though sa Article 51 ng UN Charter at saka dun sa MDP, hindi siya magpo-force sa definition ng armed attack.
But while it is not an armed attack, he says what the Chinese did clearly violated a number of international and domestic laws.
The PRC violates a lot of domestic and international laws, including use of illegal force, violation of Coal Reg, Convention on the Collision at the Sea, at saka yung SOLAS, International Convention on Safety of Life at Sea, at saka, of course, in the Declaration of Conduct, dapat ang lahat ng member states should exercise self-restraint and always opt the use of peaceful means to settle disputes.
Meanwhile, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. thumbed down the proposal of the National Maritime Council to publicize the schedule of its future RORE missions.
Just to clarify, no, those are just part of the recommendations of the National Maritime Council. It's not the decision of the president yet, but the president has decided, he said, there will be no publication of future RORE.
We reiterate that we seek neither permission nor consent from anyone in performing our sworn duties in the West Philippine Sea.
The Department of Foreign Affairs, meanwhile, says the Philippine government will continue to explore diplomatic measures to address the rising tensions in the West Philippine Sea. According to DFA Acting Secretary Maria Teresa Lazaro, the Philippine government is looking at summoning the Chinese envoy to shed light on the recent incident in Ayungin.
China, meanwhile, insists on its illegal claims in the West Philippine Sea. Beijing's foreign ministry accuses Manila of misleading the international community over their maritime row. It also continues to dispute the account of the Philippines on their encounter in Ayungin Shoal last week.
First of all, the truths and falsehoods of the China-Philippines maritime disputes are very clear. And China has repeatedly explained what the situation is in regards to those, in addition to stating China's solemn position on the matter. If the Philippine side is really willing to act in accordance with international law, it should first follow the principles that define the territory of the Philippines. China urges the Philippine side to stop its infringements and provocations and stop misleading the international community.
Ayungin Shoal is inside the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines, and China's claims have already been invalidated by Manila's 2016 arbitral victory. Vindication for former Senator Leyla de Lima, the fierce critic of the bloody drug war, cleared of all drug charges filed against her during the Duterte administration. More from Adrian Alien.
The last thorn in her legal battles was finally removed, and a jubilant Lila De Lima could not contain her joy inside the sala of Muntinlupa City Regional Trial Court Branch 206, presiding judge Jenner Guito. Outside the courtroom, her supporters also celebrated their legal victory. The court granted the demur to evidence filed by De Lima for lack of prosecution evidence after government prosecutors presented their case. De Lima and her co-accused were effectively acquitted by the court in her case, which she has been saying is a mere fabrication of the Duterte administration.
Ito po ang message ko sa dating Pangulo kay Ginoong Duterte. Kayo ngayon ang mananagot sa mga kasalanan niyo sa taong bayan. Isa lang po akong biktima. Libo-libo mga Pilipino ang pinaslang nila noong nakaraang madugo at peking war on drugs.
It was in November last year when the same court granted bail to De Lima, which led to her freedom. The most vocal critic of the then Duterte administration was arrested in February 2017 and was detained inside Camp Crame. De Lima says she will continue to help in the International Criminal Court probe against Duterte on alleged extrajudicial killings at the height of the war on drugs.
Tumutulong po ako dyan, tutulong po ako, and kaya nga po yung naging mensahe ko kay Ginoong Duterte ay siya ngayon ang mananagot. Kailangan panagutin dahil wala namang nangyayari dito sa Pilipinas. Konting-konti lang yung na-prosecute at nako-convict nila.
De Lima thanked God, Judge Guito, her family, legal team, and supporters who stood by her since day one.
Sa taong bayan na tumutok sa mga kaso ko, salamat po. At sabay-sabay pa nating tutukan ang paniniguro na mababayaran ng mga abusado sa kapangyarihan at mga umalipusta sa mga karapatang pantao.
In a social media post, former Senator Francis Pangilinan laments the 7 years it took before De Lima was acquitted, adding it is a huge blow to the Philippine justice system. Another De Lima ally, Senator Risa Ontiveros, calls on authorities to hold accountable those behind the wrongful incarceration of the former Justice Secretary. The family of the late President Benigno Aquino III believes he will be relieved to see De Lima, who served as his Justice Secretary, is now vindicated. For the prosecution, they may file a motion for reconsideration or other legal remedies available.
We are not discounting the possibility of exhausting all proper legal remedies. And as head of the panel, maybe this week I will convene all the members to discuss whether or not we will file a motion for reconsideration or any other legal remedies. We are also very happy for the good senator because once upon a time, she was our former boss.
Meanwhile, the minor case of disobedience to summons before the Quezon City Metropolitan Trial Court in connection with the congressional probe at the height of controversies involving De Lima was also dismissed. After more than 7 years of legal battle, De Lima says she has a lot of plans on her plate. But as to politics, it is still too early to tell. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.
The international community lauds the acquittal of former Senator De Lima on her last remaining drug case. U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines Mary Kay Carlson welcomed the news, saying Washington supports the rule of law and respect for fundamental freedoms around the world. European Union Ambassador Luc Veron calling the decision a victory for justice. The Dutch ambassador, meanwhile, says they find inspiration in De Lima's quest for human rights and justice. As for Germany's ambassador, it urges the Philippine government to quickly resolve all cases of extrajudicial killings and to bring perpetrators to justice. Philippine Senator Sonny Angara clearing things up amid rumors he may be the next education chief. Angara's name has been floated as a possible replacement for Vice President Sara Duterte, who resigned from the post last week. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, who leads the Senate's Basic Education Committee, also recommended Angara, citing his longtime advocacy for education. But Angara says he has yet to receive an offer. Some teachers' groups, meanwhile, believe the next DepEd chief should be a non-political figure with a real experience in the academe. President Marcos will have almost a month to choose a replacement to Duterte, whose resignation will take effect on July 19th. Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian recommends the suspension of Porac Mayor Jing Capil. This follows his survey of the Lucky South 99 compound, a sprawling Pogo complex in Porac, Pampanga, where over 150 foreigners, some allegedly victims of torture, were rescued during a raid earlier this month.
Para sa akin, hindi pwedeng alisin ng local government yung kanilang accountability. Hindi pwedeng alisin ng barangay yung kanilang accountability, lalo na sa ganitong scale, no? Dahil 2,000 dayuhan, ha? pumapasok, lumalabas, at hindi ka pinapapasok doon sa lugar, dapat nagdududa ka na kaagad. Sa laki nga nito, ang unang tanong ko, paano nakalusot to sa local government unit, paano rin nakalusot to sa barangay? Ang mayor merong napakalawak na kapangyarihan yan. Pwede niyang in-inspection yung sanitation.
Mayor Capil, however, insists the blame should be on the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation.
Parang awkward naman po na after this kami po ang nasisisi dahil kami nga ang nagkasal. Sa kanila po ang lahat ng power, pero yung accountability sa LGU po ba?
Sino po tinutukoy niyo po?
I think di Pagkor, dapat siya yung may accountabilities dito.
The connections of embattled Bambantarlac Mayor Alice Go to illegal offshore gaming hubs in her town and in Porac are becoming clearer. That's according to the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, citing a digital footprint and a paper trail of her activities. PAOC also says Go has ties to a person of interest in the case against the Pogo hubs. PAOC believes the Pogo hubs in Porac and Bamban are operated by the same criminal organization and that Go is involved. The commission is gathering more evidence as it prepares to file additional charges against Go. An anti-cybercrime group questioning the move of the National Bureau of Investigation to publicly link tech expert Art Samaniego in the string of cyber attacks without sufficient proof. An IT officer of a media firm Manila Bulletin has accused Samaniego of masterminding the hacking of some government websites which he allegedly used for his column. The Philippine Computer Emergency Response Team says authorities should not have allowed the suspect to publicly identify Samaniego. The hacker also apologizes for naming Samaniego.
Why was Art Samaniego's name revealed in a press conference when the identities of the alleged perpetrators was not? They should have withheld the name of Art Samaniego in the meantime.
Malaki po yung utang na loob sa kanya, sa nagawa niya, sa kanya, sa natulungan niya ako sa bullying. Pero sorry, Sir Art, kasi ganito nangyari.
The NBI is set to subpoena Samaniego to answer the allegations against him. The arrested hacker, meanwhile, flags the lack of cybersecurity in the websites of government agencies and private firms, which he says made it easier for him to penetrate their systems.
Humihingi po ako ng paumanhin sa mga aking mga biktima, lalo na po kay ating Pangulong Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos. Pinagsisisihan ko po yung aking ginagawa. Pero dapat mag-invest sila kahit papaano, kasi kung hindi sila mag-invest, once na ma-breach sila, mas malaki yung gagastos nila.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Benison Estradeja.
Good morning, Bettina, and to all our viewers. For now, we have the easterlies affecting the eastern sections of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So expect cloudy skies with some scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over eastern Visayas, central Visayas, Caraga region, Bicol region, as well as the provinces of Romblon, Quezon, and Palawan. On the other hand, Metro Manila and the rest of the country will still have partly cloudy to cloudy skies, especially in the morning up until noontime. And from afternoon up until evening, expect mostly cloudy skies and some isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to localized thunderstorms. Temperature over Metro Manila will range from 25 to 33 degrees Celsius, whereas Baguio will have 18 to 25 degrees Celsius. Based on our latest satellite animation, we are not monitoring any weather disturbance, whether it be low pressure area or tropical cyclone, that will affect our country in the coming days. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benison Estareja reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Benison.